My plane is going to be grounded by the FAA in 2 days if I don't get her inspected by a mechanic. Weather's closing in, today's the only day we can fly. We got no time to waste. Let's get going.
Welcome on board, guys. Those of you who are Mooney drivers have, I'm sure, heard of the new airworthiness directive that the FAA have issued. Now, that airworthiness directive is on the elevator. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about it a little bit later on. But the purpose of this flight is to fly to Gainesville to see my mechanic, my A&P IA. That's the airplane power plant mechanic with inspection authority. So he's going to look over my elevator. He needs to sign off my logbook. He's the only guy who can actually do it. I don't have that type of authority as a pilot. Now, airworthiness directives are actually mandatory. Mooney had already issued an SB, which is a service bulletin, which is kind of optional, but, you know, highly recommended that folks follow. But then the FAA came around with this Airworthiness Directive AD, and now that thing is mandatory, and if you don't do it by a certain date, your airplane is grounded. I don't want to be grounded with my airplane, so let's go to Gainesville and check this thing out. All right, we are at the Hold Short Bars, Gwinnett Tower, Mooney 112 Papa Hotel, ready at Yankee 25.
112 Papa Hotel, Gwinnett Tower, on course, runway 25, clear for takeoff.
On course, runway 25, clear for takeoff, to Papa Hotel. Here we go. Gwinnett has lots of birds, so we're going to be looking out for those. Runway 25. Runway 25. Setting heading indicator. There we go. Up. Everything's in the green.
Tower, Skyhawk 8252 Lima 10 Northeast with Fox Trot, full stop.
Lima 8252 Lima, Gwinnett Tower, 43 mile final, runway 25.
43 mile final, 2552 Lima.
Southwest 880 is ready.
So we took off from Gwinnett. And we're already at 3,000 feet, which is going to be our cruising altitude for our very short flight here to Gainesville. So this airworthiness directive is on the elevator counterbalance weight. Now, what does a counterbalance weight actually do? Well, according to the engineers, it reduces the risk of flutter. What is flutter? Well, flutter is a oscillating tendency of an aircraft, and that's supposed to somehow reduce it. So it's actually pretty important to have this counterweight in there. Now, Mooney, originally 50 years ago, when they put the counterweight into this airplane, for certain models, they decided to combine aluminum? Okay, I don't know how you pronounce it. Anyway, combine that with steel. So they put this block of aluminum and a steel rod inside as a weight. Of course, as you guys probably know, steel and the other substance don't combine very well. And of course, after time, after 50 years now, they found that it's actually come apart on some aircraft. So that's bad news. But it only affected certain builds of the Mooney. And they don't really know which ones they put it into and which ones they didn't. So that's why the AD is coming out for
canceled traffic.
Gainesville traffic, Mooney 112 Papa Hotel on the 45 for left downwind runway 23 Gainesville. Gainesville traffic, Mooney 112 Papa Hotel is on the left downwind runway 23 Gainesville. Landing lights on, fuel pump on, prop full forward. Below gear extension speed, gear going down. Gear is down. Gainesville traffic, Mooney 112 Papa Hotel turning left base, runway 23 Gainesville. Gear is down and locked and indicating. And we can see the runway there, nobody on the right. Gainesville traffic, Mooney, 112 pop out till turning finals, runway 23 Gainesville.
It's time to find out if I'm grounded or if I dodged a bullet. If you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing. If you like the video, hit that like button. That does actually help. So let's go get inspected. I'll be right back. Wish me luck. It passed. No hybrid counterweight on my plane. It looks like a solid block of aluminum. So logbook is signed. Now it's time to head back to Gwinnett. Thanks for joining the flight. See you on the next video.